Hey you, so today I was thinking about the book of Acts and the story of Peter and John as they were walking past the temple, and then they met this old man, the lame man that needed their help, and they did not have anything to give to him, but all they had was empowering him to rise up and walk in the name of Jesus. So this made me think about the word empowering each other, empowering, you know, someone, empowering one another. So sometimes we tend to underplay an empowerment or a word of empowerment from a brother and a sister, from a friend, and especially in situations where maybe we need physical help from them, or something tangible like maybe finances, or maybe a specific thing that is really that requires them to have to actually do something for you. So and then sometimes we find ourselves not in position to do anything about it. So I think that we shouldn't underplay the power that is in empowering one another. There's so much that that can come out of empowering another person, and sometimes that's all that someone needs, to shoot for the stars. Sometimes that's all that someone needs, to start that thing that they've been trying to start for 10 years. Or, you know, sometimes that is all that is needed, only if the person who is receiving it receives it. And in most cases, if you don't receive it, then that's where it won't work. But I think that we should be, we should open up our hearts and open up our minds and just receive, to receive all these good things that people sow into us. And sometimes we ignore, or we don't take them so seriously, or we underplay them because it's not like a physical thing. It's not money, or it's not a property, or it's not, it's just the word. But sometimes if it's an empowered and a blessed word, that word, when you receive it, it's going to do wonders for your life. So that is all I wanted to share with someone today. I hope that you are blessed. Godspeed in everything. Bye bye.